We now begin to introduce the idea of buffer solutions. The first thing to realize is that a buffer solution is a solution that will resist a change in pH. And we'll talk specifically about the criteria for this, but it's important to remember that a buffer solution will only resist a change in pH when we add small amounts of substances. There is a certain point when a buffer won't work anymore and we might see a dramatic change in pH. So we say they resist change in pH. What will happen is as we go through pH calculations, we'll see that there will be a slight change in pH, but it will be very minimal compared to the change if we didn't have a buffer solution. For our first example, we discuss what happens when we add sodium acetate to a solution of acetic acid. So recognize down here, the equation we show is acetic acid reacting in water to produce hydronium and the acetate ion. And notice we have offset equilibrium arrows because this is a reactant favored system. So just acetic acid in water, we would have primarily reactants at equilibrium and very little of our products. So this system sets up equilibrium. That's one of the first criteria for a buffer solution. The second criteria is that buffers are an example of what's called the common ion effect. What we mean by that is that we are combining two solutions that have an ion in common. And so notice here, we are starting with acetic acid in water, and we want to know what's going to happen when we add sodium acetate to it. Recognize that it's the acetate ion that is in common in both. And so therefore, by combining these two solutions together, acetic acid and sodium acetate, we have created a common ion effect. Now the addition of the sodium acetate, if I add it to this equilibrium system of acetic acid, the sodium acetate is going to cause a shift in my equilibrium. The reason for that is because of what happens. So we know sodium acetate is a soluble salt. It will dissociate into the sodium ion and the acetate ion. So by adding these two solutions together, first of all, another side note for you, recognize that those two solutions are not going to react with each other. I cannot use this as my starting point for a reaction. So realize if I try to combine, or if I combine acetic acid with sodium acetate, the only type of reaction that could happen would be a double replacement where my hydrogen and my sodium would switch places. And if that happens, notice that my products are exactly the same as my reactants. So in other words, this is not the reaction that's taking place. They don't react with each other. That's another criteria of buffers. We have a common ion. We also have two solutions that do not react with each other. So the only reaction that's taking place is the shift of the equilibrium of our acetic acid equilibrium system. So recognize by adding pure acetate, sodium's going to be a spectator ion. What I've done is I've effectively increased the concentration of the acetate ion, right? That came straight from the sodium acetate. I increase the concentration of the acetate ion. When I do that, Le Chatelier says that our equilibrium is going to shift back to the left. When our equilibrium shifts back to the left, then we see a decrease. After the shift, we see a decrease in the concentration of hydronium. When there's a decrease in the concentration of hydronium, of course, then we expect our pH to increase. I'm going to erase some notes here so I can summarize all of this on one slide for you. So again, when we add the common ion, in this case, the acetate ion, both solutions contain this. When we do that, we are forcing the equilibrium system to shift backwards. When that shifts in the reverse direction, we see that our hydronium ion concentration decreases. And when that decreases, the pH of a solution increases. For a cleaner version of that, here we see the second equation. Again, notice our sodium acetate completely dissociates. The sodium ion is completely neutral. And so by adding this acetate ion, we are effectively adding it to the equilibrium system of our acetic acid. And so the short version is a solution that contains a weak acid and its conjugate base, or a weak base and its conjugate acid, is a buffer solution. So notice in our example, our weak acid is the acetic acid, and we always have to start with a weak substance that will set up equilibrium. We added to this the salt of its conjugate base, so sodium acetate. Notice the acetate ion is the conjugate base. No negative there, sorry. The acetate ion is the conjugate base of acetic acid. And so we added a salt of its conjugate base. So notice we have the weak acid. By adding the conjugate base, that's how we get the common ion. And of course, we could make a buffer using a weak base and making a salt out of its conjugate acid. We'll go through one example of that, but it's far more common to work with acidic solutions, acidic buffer solutions. So again, buffer solutions will resist a change in pH when we add small amounts of a strong acid or a strong base. And they do this because they already contain both a weak acid and a weak base that don't react and don't neutralize each other. So the main chemical equation to show the solution of a buffer looks like this one down here. This equation is the chemical equation for a buffer. It looks just like the dissociation of the weak acid or the weak base. The only difference is we don't know it's a buffer until we're told that we are adding the common ion to it. So a little bit more specific about how a buffer works. So we have this original solution of a buffer. Again, it contains a weak acid and a weak base that is the conjugate of our weak acid. So when we add a small amount of a strong base, realize that acetic acid is my acid. So if I add some strong base, it is going to react with the weak acid. It will decrease the amount of acetic acid that I have in solution and use that up, and it will actually increase the amount of the conjugate base that I have. So all it's doing is shifting the equilibrium. Same idea when we add a small amount of strong acid to a buffer. Now the strong acid that I add is going to react with the base part of my buffer. It's going to decrease the amount of the buffer's base that I have in solution and increase the amount of the weak acid that I have. So again, buffers need to be made with, first of all, a weak acid or base, and then we add a common ion in the form of its conjugate. Great way to practice is to look at pairs of solutions, either by formula or by name, and identify whether each pair will make a buffer solution. I'll ask you to pause the video here and identify your answer to each one. When you play the video again, we'll review those answers. So go ahead and pause the video now and replay when you have your answers ready. Okay, I'm going to assume you have answers. So let's go through each pair and identify if they can make a buffer solution. Notice here we have a weak acid. We have a salt made from its conjugate base. And so, yes, this would make a good buffer solution. Number two, we have ammonia. Recognize that ammonia, of course, is NH3. That's our favorite example of a weak base. The ammonium ion is its conjugate acid. And then, of course, we add bromide to it to make a salt. So we have a weak base and its conjugate acid combined together will make a buffer. The third example, although we have a common ion, recognize that neither one of these is a weak acid or a weak base. So that would not make a good buffer solution. Example number four is very similar to the example we've already used. The only difference is I used a different cation in here. That has no bearing on our buffer because it's neutral. And so this combination of solutions will make a buffer. And again, you need to be familiar with nomenclature. Nitric acid is a strong acid, and sodium nitrate, although it's its conjugate base, a strong acid will not make a buffer solution. Chlorous acid, again, nomenclature, chlorous acid, ClO2 minus, that is one of our, or HClO2, sorry, is a weak acid. And then chlorite ion is its conjugate base. So yes, that will make a buffer solution, a weak acid with the salt of its conjugate base. The example with NaOH and NaCl, again, we have a common ion here, but nothing is weak. We don't have a weak acid or a weak base, so that would be a no. This last one, if I give you a hint to think about it, means that it's going to go against your intuition. At first glance, we would say no. However, realize that when I put these solutions in water, we know HCl completely dissociates, and we know sodium acetate completely dissociates. We have all of these ions floating around in water together. And if hydrogen and acetate see each other, they will stick together to a small degree. Not completely, and so we'll still have acetate ion floating around, but then we also form acetic acid. So we can force a buffer solution to form under the right circumstances. That is an exception to the rule. It's not a common one that we use. In fact, it's not in any of the examples, but recognize that there are other ways to force a reaction to form a buffer. And in our next video, we will start to describe how we calculate the pH of buffer solutions.